All right, we're going to get started. So welcome to Alamitos Beach for a very, very special occasion. I'm Brent Dennis. I serve all of you as your Director of Parks, Recreation, and Marine. And we're very proud of everything that's floating behind me. It's really a great moment to gather together and dedicate and celebrate one of the best new recreational amenities on the waterfront here in Long Beach. So we always like to start our programs honoring our country. And I've recruited this young lady. Her name's Charlotte from South Shores. She just graduated from fourth grade, going into fifth grade, and she's one of our junior lifeguards. So she's gonna, let's hear it for the lifeguard program. So Charlotte's gonna lead us. So those of you that are able to stand, we'll take off our hats, and Charlotte, it's all yours. Please join me.
Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Thank you, Charlotte. The reason I recruited her is she's actually going to go return to her first place in line. She's going to be the first swimmer to be able to make their way out to the Wibit. So you can go ahead. There you go. All right. So we do have a few speakers here that we want to allow them to share some of their thoughts and excitement about this great new addition to Alamitos Beach. I do want to give a couple shout outs. So our beach maintenance team actually installed this ADA access mat, which made it very easy for a lot of you to make it all the way down here to the waterfront. In the near future, we actually have three more that will be installed in various locations along our beachfront, and hopefully in the future we'll additionally add better access to our beach. But I wanted to point that out. Also, our Marine Bureau team, Elvita Helenin's over here, and Todd Leland, they also really did a great job in helping put together our event setting. So we thank and appreciate you. So it's an honor to welcome our Vice Mayor, Rex Richardson, to the podium to share a few of his sentiments. So good morning or good afternoon and welcome, Vice Mayor.
Let's hear it for our incredible Parks and Recreations team, led by Brent Dennis. We are here for the Wibit cutting. Wibit, not Wibit. This was not named by Elmer Fudd. It's Wibit, not Wibit. On behalf of the City of Long Beach, I am very excited here to showcase a new addition to our city's waterfront right here at Alamitos Beach, the Wibit. This inflatable water playground is the second of its kind in the city, and it will help further activate our beaches. And we know that when we activate our beaches and we activate our parks, we have safer and healthier parks. So we're gonna activate this beach all summer long with this Wibit. The Wibit has made its original debut at Alamitos Bay next to Leeway Sailing Aquatic Center. How many people saw the original Wibit? Okay, how many people are excited to check out this Wibit? Anybody excited? I am too. It's gonna become a staple in Long Beach. When people think of summertime in the LBC, they're gonna think of fun things like the Wibit here at Alamitos Beach and other installations all around our coastline. And the city knew that this was an essential next step for us. So what brings us here today, behind me, you can see those bright colors, this amazing Wibit. There's different levels, you'll hear about it. There's, I think, a 1 meter, a 2 meter, a 3 meter diving board. And no one does it like this. There's no other city that activates its coastline that has an open water Wibit. There's no other city that does this. This is doing the ocean, the beachfront, the Long Beach way. Let's hear it for the Long Beach way. So we are excited for this. I've got my little ones. They have their swimsuits on and their swim shoes on under their dresses. We're gonna go have some fun at the beach today. So without further ado, I wanna introduce the second district councilwoman, my good friend, Cindy Allen.
Thank you, Vice Mayor Rex Richardson. I appreciate that. Hey, welcome to I'm just so happy that you're all here. Welcome. This is an exciting day. You know, this Wibit, it has so many great attractions to it. I had the opportunity to get out there yesterday, and it is hard. And I want to follow up on what Vice Mayor Rex Richardson said. No one else has this like we do. The cities that do have this, they charge $20 to come and for the kids to come play. And we do it for free. So can I give that up to the city of Long Beach? And also I want to give a huge shout out to Brent Dennis and to our city manager, Tom Modica, for making this happen for our community. Thank you, Tom. I mean, kids can come from all over, from North Long Beach all the way down to downtown to come enjoy this. So we're so appreciative. So kids, who thinks that they can get through this entire obstacle course without falling? Raise your hand. All right. I see a lot of hands raised. Anyone that gets through this entire course without falling needs to contact me because I have something special for you. I have some special recognition, all right? So listen, everybody enjoy. Thank you for being here. And I officially want to say that this is going to be open in a couple minutes. Thank you.
Thank you, Vice Mayor, and thank you, Councilwoman Allen. We appreciate your leadership and your advocacy for keeping Long Beach fun. So our Parks, Recreation, and Marine Department works very closely with Public Works. And if his schedule would have allowed, my colleague Eric Lopez would have been here. He's the director doing really amazing things throughout the city. But one of his colleagues, Josh Hickman, who actually was the project manager for this amazing project, Josh is going to come forward and share a few of his sentiments. So welcome, Josh. Oh, and he participated in a triathlon right before he got here, so admire him for that.
You're giving me too much credit. Thank you, Brent. Thank you, Vice Mayor. Thank you, Councilwoman. Really excited to be here. This is a great opportunity for everybody. And what better way to kick off the summer? So officially the first weekend of summer, and we're going to be out here on a water playground. Just can't be beat. So I wanted to thank our partners at Parks, Rec, and Marine, our partners at Lifeguards, and we really couldn't have done it without the collaborative efforts all around. Also want to send a special shout out to Amelia Bodek. She's out here somewhere. Raise your hand, Amelia. This is her very first capital project at the city, so successfully completed, and very exciting to share that good news. And I also saw Lenny out here. Lenny was instrumental in getting the anchors out here. His dive team made all this possible. So thank you to everybody that participated, and enjoy the rest of the day. I'll turn it back over to Brent to close it out.
Great. Thank you, Josh. So a couple things. So obviously this line is getting longer, but Omar, who's off to my side here, he's a great leader of our amazing lifeguard staff. They were out here yesterday for kind of a trial run. It's one thing to kind of see the elements, but once you put human beings that can swim on it, all those dynamics are really important for our lifeguards to help keep it safe. So the way this works is, you kind of queue up, and there's a chute, the red chute up here, and they're going to allow 30 swimmers at a time to go out to the Wibit, and they get 15 minutes, which seems relatively fair considering the popularity. If at any time, they'll hear this repeated. If at any time a lifeguard blows a whistle for safety reasons, everyone should pause, turn their attention to the lifeguard, so they'll explain what needs to be done. Again, safety first, but fun, safety second. So someone asked, well, when is this open? Well, it officially opens today, and it will be staff from 9:30 to 7:30 every day, all the way through the Friday after Labor Day, unless by popular demand we can extend it. But we also realize that most of our lifeguards, they go back to school, so we need to make sure we have enough for that. So with that, we're going to do a ribbon cutting. Since this is a blue ribbon project, and the Marine Bureau is known for this beautiful blue. If we could have our elected officials come forward. And who else? Josh, obviously. All right. So, and we have the world's largest pair of scissors coming forward. And they always want me to move on a terra firma that's easier than this. Great. Okay, since we're in Council District 2, oh, it's a short countdown. I was going to say we'll count backward. We were in District 4 dedicating a community center this morning. So, well, anyway, yes, Joy. 1-2 Wibit, and at Wibit, they'll cut that into 2 bits. All right, so all together, 1-2 Wibit. All right.